how much nitrogen does your crop actually need? Well, it's hard to know what your yield goal is going to be exactly, but what you can determine is how much nitrogen is in the soil right now. The way to do that is with a pre-sidedress nitrate test.
When your corn is about 6 to 12 inches tall, we'd encourage you to go out in the field and pull some soil cores, at least from a 0 to 12 inch depth. Find out what's out there and what's pretty highly available for your crop. Now, some will say, well, I want to do nitrate tests down 2 feet deep, and you certainly can do that. The question is, are you going to be able to get all that nitrogen in the second foot? Now, if you say, we've had some excessive moisture here, I'm really concerned about that, you definitely could pull some deeper samples, but I'd recommend at least doing the 0 to 12 inch profile and getting a good understanding of what's happening.
All right, Darren, talk about how to pull those samples. How would you do it? Where would you pull the cores?
Well, in our 30 inch row corn, I would pick a few different soil types out there, and then I'd go out and pull a soil sample, then move over 3 inches, then go ahead a few steps, then move over 3 inches, and so forth. So you kind of get a sample throughout the zone. That way, if there was any banding, you can kind of take some of that variability out. I like 0 to 12 cores once again. It's going to cost you $5 to $10 a sample. It's really no big expense to find out what's out there for nitrogen.
One of the things I like to do is have these samples pulled where I have previous complete soil samples done. The reason why is I want to know what my soil organic matter level is. Here's where I'm going with this. If I have 1% soil organic matter out there, that means it's going to give me almost no free nitrogen during the year. So what I've got in the soil now, it's pretty much what I'm going to have. If I have 7% organic matter, on the other hand, over the course of the season, I could get 150, 200 pounds of free nitrogen coming available. And if it's early in the year, I've got a lot of that to come yet, so maybe I don't need to apply quite as much nitrogen. So this is one of the things I would factor in there.
So when you get your results back from your pre-sidedress nitrate test, you can look at land-grant universities like Iowa State that have got systems set up to show you, hey, if you pulled this many parts per million, then you should apply this many pounds of nitrogen. And you may look at universities in your area to get a more representative result for you. The other thing that you may be interested in is some of the online modeling that's been done that forecasts, hey, here's how much nitrogen should be left in your soil, and here's how much you should apply. I think those things are great. And it's nice to look at those and compare the results you're getting from your soil.
The big thing we'd really encourage you to do, again, though, is make sure you are testing, sampling, and doing some split application of nitrogen. It's the right thing for the environment, it's the right thing for your pocketbook, and it's certainly the right thing for your crop in a lot of cases.
Well, dialing your nitrogen in just right is really important for top yields, but so is controlling our weed of the week. We'll show you how to do that coming up next.